Hi, how you doing? I'm actually going to show you a little bit about Jamar Caldwell. He's a photographer.
Hi, my name is Jamar Caldwell. I own Bleusol Photography, and you're watching the Malblack Show. So my favorite subject is children. Believe it or not, kids are so untainted. They're like just non-blemished. They're just who they are. When you can show somebody how to do something and they know nothing, that way they're learning from zero. So what makes them easy to work with is the fact that they're not telling you what they want, but you can actually show them what you want, and then you don't have any interference. So the reason why I believe people would want me to take their picture, especially if they've never taken pictures before, is because I have a very comfortable spirit about me. People are automatically comfortable when they're around me. They get to know me and they warm up to me. It's really easy for them just to kind of let their guard down and just get into what I'm telling them to do or what we're trying to capture that day. So really easy to work with, fun-loving guy. So I want to work with as many people as I possibly can, especially for those people who have never done this before or been in front of the camera. It's something to pull out something in them that they've never even seen in themselves. And I'm really interested in creating memories for people. These are timeless things that you can't buy it. So the thing I like about working with professionals is that they are so serious about what they do. You know, like with a professional model, sometimes they can go out four poses and I'm like, you know what, I like what you did four poses back, and they can just go right back to it. Not only that, with them being so professional, their professionalism helps me help the ones that never taken pictures before. So whenever I'm working with people like that, you know, as much as they're learning from me, I'm learning from them, and then I transfer that to people that don't know a thing. So personal branding. There's a photographer that I follow on Facebook and Twitter and so on. His name is Jared Poland. He calls himself the Fro. So you imagine a guy that calls himself the Fro, so that automatically puts you in the mind of an Afro. It's a white guy. His Afro's this big. But he has a t-shirt line called I Shoot Raw. Of course, it has crazy connotations to it. But it's his branding. So anytime I see him say I Shoot Raw, I automatically think Jared Poland. So whenever I'm branding a person, I try to find the thing about them, like their own it factor. You know, these are things that only they have. Everybody's unique to what they do. So I try to catch them in what they do. So say if it's a hairdresser, someone that's known for the way that they can make hair lay down or, you know, curls or what have you. I try to catch them doing just that so that whenever people see them, it's like, oh, that's the lady who can make my hair nice, you know, or so on. And then when we get into like product branding, you have to find a way to infuse what it is into what it does. So the way I got started, early in my life, my mom would always try to find different things for me to do. Just as a child, you know, growing up in the neighborhood, and she didn't want me to be typical. You know, she didn't want me to be like just, you know, average black kid, play baseball, football, basketball, and just that be the my ticket out or whatever. But what it was is that she actually found a program through Opera Carolina, which is actually where I learned that I could sing. I had no idea. that I could sing. I was getting offers from Opera Carolina to do operas when I was in high school. But that really just transferred energy from the artistic process of learning to sing, learning to act, and then it just kind of trained my eye to what things are supposed to look like. So from that, I actually started to like visual arts. Never painted, never, you know, any photography or anything like that, but I just knew when I saw something, I liked it. So just to fast forward from there, in college, I would buy these Kodak throwaway cameras, and on Sundays on campus, I would just go around and just take pictures of different things on campus that I just absolutely loved. We had a beautiful campus, went to Salem State University. Lots of blooms, flowers, trees, and so on. And I would just walk around and take pictures. Of course, that was long before digital, long before we were able to afford a digital camera. I managed the band while I was there. I'd always take pictures and video of the band. Later on, after college and so on. But then one day, I was working in an audio store. Our store was closing, and I was wondering what I was gonna do with myself. And then I just had to really look inward and say, well, what do I like? And I've always liked music, art. I always loved expression. So I remember one day I was at lunch with my wife. I'd just been laid off. It was April 09. Actually, it was probably March 09. I was thinking in my head, like, how am I gonna ask my wife to spend over $1,000 and I don't have a job? Yeah. So it's funny, I was thinking this, and she looked at me and said, what'd you say? And I didn't say a word. So I said, well, no time like the present. So I said, hey, what do you think about me buying a camera? And she just kind of looked at me and she said, well, are you gonna start a business with it? I'm like, well, yeah. But the thing about when I bought the camera, the very next day, I was working in photography. The very next day. Found a guy on Craigslist. They were doing a photo shoot at this art gallery. They had different people coming in to just take pictures and so on. And the next thing you know, he said, well, man, I could really make more money if I had some help. And I was like, I'm not doing anything. So I said, well, I'll come with you. Didn't even think about making money at all. I just wanted to learn how to use my own camera. So the way that my whole art started, in the fifth grade, I was going to the music room to actually sign up to play the trumpet. And you know, all the boys played brass instruments or drums, and all those positions were taken. So I was, you know, a little sad, like, man, I want to play an instrument, you know. And I was walking out of the music room, and Miss Jackson, Karen Jackson, she actually looked up and said, hey, Jamar, what about the cello? I was like, okay. So I started playing the cello, and that is where my whole world opened up, you know, in a completely different light. Because again, black kid, black neighborhood, you play football, you play basketball. But I played football, and I had a cello in my hand in the fifth grade. So talk about balls. You know, it just didn't work, you know, like that then, in that time. So from there, that's where, you know, I learned that I could sing later on. You know, I learned that I like visual arts later on. The next thing you know, I'm a photographer. So thank you, Miss Jackson.